And welcome. This is Omega Broadcasting Network English Service. This is our special edition. In this program, we're going to see issues of cultures and tourism in Oromia regional government. My guest today is Dr. Garamo Luka. He is Bureau Head of Oromia Culture and Tourism. Welcome to our program, Doctor.
Thank you.
Okay, let's start with the issues of cultures and the tourism. What are the major responsibilities of Oromia Cultures and the Tourism Bureaus?
Okay, thank you very much for inviting me. The Oromia Bureau of Culture and the Tourism has many responsibilities, particularly focusing on the culture of Oromo society and tourism in Oromia. So the main vision of our bureau is to preserve, develop and promote Oromo culture, as well as to develop, promote and make use of Oromia tourism resources.
Okay. As known, 6 years ago, the Gada system of Oromo people inscribed as intangible heritage of United Nations UNESCO.
Yeah.
What is brought to Gada system after that?
Okay. By the way, basically, Gada is a part and parcel of culture of Oromo society that the Oromo have invented before many thousands of years. And as everybody knows, for the last one century, Gada was directly or indirectly banned by the feudal and the military government. But in some of Oromia parts, Gada survived, even though there were external pressures. So in the last 15 to 20 years, Gada renewed, revitalized itself. And as a result of that, Gada was able to be registered as World Heritage. So, but the benefit we have got after registration is maybe the world have known it, and it became World Heritage, and so that the world has a responsibility of preserving and safeguarding this heritage. But in material-wise, maybe support-wise, nothing has came to Gada system after registration even.
What is the reason behind the cannot support in the promotion of Gada system as well as in the Oromia assets of Ethiopia?
Yeah, you know, UNESCO is working with Ethiopia, but with the Oromia regional government. It's a procedure, by the way. So it is the responsibility of the Ministry of Culture and Tourism of this country to deal with UNESCO, not only for Gada, but also for other inscribed resources, to get some material as well as financial support to promote as well as to develop Gada. So we have been trying to communicate with the Federal Archive and Heritage Management Agency, but we could not be successful. We don't know the reason. And we will try our best still to communicate and to maybe generate some resources to help Gada to develop.
What is the problem in the process?
I don't know, but we have appointment with to deal with this issue with the Ministry of Culture and with the UNESCO director in the coming week. So I hope we will discuss this issue in detail with the director of UNESCO. But we actually, that is not a very basic issue. What we have to do is that Gada should rely on Oromo society's resource and Ethiopian society's resource. This does not mean that we do not need help from international organizations, specifically UNESCO. UNESCO has mandate to help or to support, to safeguard this heritage. But as our bureau, focus is that how to generate resource from Oromia, how generate resource from Oromo people so that we can sustain Gada system. It's, UNESCO's help is secondary for us.
In most parts of Oromia region and where the Oromo nationals are living and residing, the Gada system, now it is on the restoration process. Some experts or historians argue that there is the problem in the restoration process. Do you agree with this?
Yeah, of course, there are many problems, but there are also many positive things. Yeah. Are you asking me to list the problems? Or, yeah, I support, this argument. You know, you cannot say that there is no problem.
Yeah.
Because, you know, Gada, we are trying to regenerate Gada. It is, not material culture, you know. It's very easy to regenerate easily material culture. But intangible heritages are very difficult because you are dealing with people's mind. You don't have remnants, you cannot dig remnants and study them. So when you deal with people's memory, people's understanding, you have to have time and you have to have appropriate sources. So where is our maybe rich source in Gada is Borana, Guji, and Karayu. Other parts of Oromia, in other parts of Oromia, Gada was highly affected, negatively affected by external as well as internal factors like religion and the politics. So you have to sit down and study the history and ask the elders and bring for and teach the generation. That was very challenging and still is challenging. But you know, Oromo society is very interesting society. It's cultural society, you can say. The people who love its culture, so that for the last 20 years, everybody gave attention to Gada, and especially to promoting Gada and showing interest to promote Gada is very high. That is a positive part of this restoration. But in the areas I mentioned before, the problems are history was highly affected. Who is the actual Bagada? Who is not? Selecting who is the actual Bagada and who is not is one of the challenge. Actually, in the first case, in before 10 years, even people, most people do not know about Gada, and they did not have interest to show to be part of this Gada system. Only few individuals who know some history and have interest came to the front, and these individuals consider themselves as practitioners or Bagadas or whatever you call.
That is what's a challenge in the Gada system in some areas. It's the main challenge.
Yeah, such kind of, when you bring these individuals, when you see, yeah, it was positive because you don't have someone who was appropriate. The negative part is that these guys do not know much history and they are not the actual Bagadas. So now when you think to bring the actual Bagadas, these guys maybe be disappointed. And of course, particularly in the central part and the Macha area, the western part of Oromia, the so-called modern bureaucracy affected this Gada system in restoring this Gada system, because this generation is a generation of bureaucracy, not the generation of Gada and Macha and the Tulama. So they try to govern Gada in the form of modern bureaucracy, like in writing letter, in having minute.
Okay, and doctor, most of Oromo scholars in the many times or in the studies recommended that the Gada system should have to consider in the curriculum of this country, especially in universities, and also the students have to learn in their primary education. What's you, the Oromia Culture Tourism Bureau are working on this?
Yeah, look, one of the ways to sustain Gada is to make part of curriculum so that the generation learners this Gada very huge, sophisticated and philosophical system in the school. So our bureau is doing its best consulting, for example, Oromia Educational Bureau we are dealing with. We are claiming that Gada is matured enough to be part of curriculum in this country, at least in Oromia, as well as in university, whatever. Secondly, we have been doing and working and consulting with different universities in Oromia. Like I can mention two to three universities who have done their best to open an institute that focuses on Gada
studies.
Yes, like Bulehora University very recently, as well as Aromai University. I myself participated last year in curriculum development in Institute of Gada Study. Also, okay. We do have Juma University we can mention in the Oromo Oromo folklore or whatever the name. Maybe they teach Gada issues in that department, but this is not suffice. So we are encouraging other universities to deal with Gada Study. But when we come to Oromia Educational Bureau, we need to be Gada to be part of curriculum, not as a subject, okay. But not as a topic and a chapter, but as a subject. To do this, we have proposed the government to help us as a project next year to study how to include Gada into curriculum. So we have given focus on this issue.
Did you believe that the problems currently seen in the process of restoring Gada system can be solved when the Gada system added in the this country's education curriculum?
No, it has its own value. It may contribute in this way. That means not to solve the problem, but to make Gada well known from generation to generation. You see, now who is knowledgeable about Gada is the elders, but they are not part of the school. Gada is not part of the school. The young individuals who go to school do not have chance to learn Gada. To learn Gada, you have to maybe get these Bagadas and you have to be part of that ritual. So to make it normal process of this country, it has to be part of curriculum so that formally our students can learn Gada in the school as other, as we learn other issues, science, mathematics, whatever you have, history, whatever you have. So Gada is very has potential and it is very rich to be learned. It is very complex philosophy, by the way. So our argument is like this. Our bureau is arguing that Gada has to be part of curriculum, not to solve this restoration problem, by the way, just to make Gada sustains or continue from generation to generation, that we are demanding the curriculum. But this restoration problem will be solved very, very soon and very easily, but it needs attention of the Oromo people. By the way, Gada is not, it does not belong to the Bagadas. Gada belongs to Oromo society, you see? So it has to be part of Oromo people's day-to-day life. It has to be re-inculcated into the life of the society, okay? So that is very important. Otherwise, if you connect Gada simply to some Abagada and whatever, who is very interested in that part and detached from the society, you cannot sustain Gada and you cannot restore Gada. That is very important issue that we have to do.